Today we're talking about Orasol dyes. Now, Orasol dyes are a dry artist pigment. They used to be made by Ciba-Geigy, then they were taken over by BASF. Now it's Sun Chemical, I believe, that makes the Orasol dyes. Doesn't matter who manufactures it though, it's basically a really strong dry artist pigment. We sell them in these tiny little containers because it does not take much of the Orasol to color your materials. The majority of the time you're going to use Orasols with your HXTAL or XTR or other epoxies like that. Today I'm going to walk you through how to tint your HXTAL to create colored joints in your pieces. So I have some pieces here that I am going to be joining. I'm not going to do those today, but you'll see them at the end of this video as we'll have to do this tomorrow. Today we're going to talk about actually mixing our Orasol dyes for our HXTAL. Now HXTAL comes in two parts. It's a two-part epoxy. You have a resin part A and a hardener part B. Now I like to mix my Orasol dyes in my part B. Part B of HXTAL is the thinner viscosity of the two materials. So it makes mixing in the Orasol dye a little easier. It makes filtering the Orasol dye a little easier. Now you can mix it in your part A because your part A is going to be three times as much as your part B in your mixture if you want to try and get a more accurate reading of what your color is going to be like once you've mixed your HXTAL. If you do use your part A, I tend to recommend you warming this up either in a hot box at about 100 degrees or in a microwave for a few seconds to thin down the viscosity of the part A. Part A is not terribly problematic with heat, part B is. You really don't want to heat up part B too much or it will cause it to yellow slightly, which will change the color of your eventual joint. Now today I'm going to mix our Orasol dye blue 855 into our HXTAL part B and kind of show you how that works. So I've measured out some part B of HXTAL. I only have really one joint to do. So I measured out a little bit of extra because I'm going to both mix my Orasol in here and filter it. So I'm going to lose some of my part B in this. So I want to make sure I have enough to accurately measure out for the small amount of part A that I need for my HXTAL joint. As with any other chemical, I'm always going to wear gloves when working with any kind of chemical. I particularly like wearing gloves when working with the Orasol dyes as they stain everything. If it gets out and gets on you, it's going to stick in your clothes and it's going to be there forever. So it's really quite problematic. So you'll see in our little Orasol container, the Orasol is a dry artist pigment. It's extremely fine. So since the Orasol is so fine, you can actually just stick your glass stirring rod into your Orasol and it's gonna pick up a fair amount of Orasol just by clinging to your glass stirring rod. Well, that's probably not quite enough, but whew, so I'm dropping a little bit into my part B of HXTAL already. So I'm already making a little bit of a mess here. So let's just start mixing some in here. And you can see I'm already generating some color here. And if you want a really strong joint, you can obviously put more in here. I am not looking at a particularly strong joint, so I don't want to overdo it. I think I'm going to grab just a little bit more out of here. Now you can see that I've got my kind of teal color from my blue 855. And if you pull in a little closer on this, you probably see in the mixture, got a lot of little chunks and bits in there. It's really hard to get this to fully go into solution. So there's a couple of things you'll want to do. First, mix this as much as you can, get as much of it into solution as you can. And once you've done that, we're going to filter it. So I'm just going to set my glass stirring rod aside and I've got a blank cup here and my filter. These are just an ultra fine filter from Sherwin-Williams or any local paint store that you have. We pick these up a case at a time and we'll take our part B and we're going to pour it into our filter into our secondary cup. And that's going to filter out the largest chunks of my Orasol that haven't mixed in well. Let that finish dripping out a little bit. We've mixed our Orasol dye into our part B of HXTAL. We've warmed it up a little bit to get it a little bit thinner. I've let this sit for about 10 or 20 minutes and I've mixed it again, let it sit for a little bit longer. You're just looking at making sure all the larger pieces of the Orasol dye are mixed in or filtered out. You've seen me filter it through the filter. So after mixing a few times and filtering it, we can use a light here to kind of look through our part B. And it'll see if we have any larger chunks in there, which I don't. It's really well mixed. I don't see any particles in there, so it should be good to go now. So I've got my digital scale, and I've already mixed out some part A, and I'm going to put an empty cup on my scale so I can zero it out. There we go. So now my part A, when I put on there, I've got right at 3 grams of part A. which means I'll need 1 gram of my part B in here. So I'm going to zero out my scale again and use my part B to mix into my part A. Yeah, I'm pretty good there. So now that I have my part B, I'll use my glass stirring rod to mix my two parts together. Now, mixing it with a glass stirring rod, you're going to introduce a lot of bubbles into your mixture. You can already see them. And you can either let this sit for a few hours and it will degas on its own, or you can put it into a vacuum chamber to degas it. Once I mix this, I'm just going to let it sit for a few hours and let it degas on its own. I have some other projects to do. And once this is degassed, we will come back and finish gluing our pieces together with our colored HXTAL. You do want to make sure this is all mixed very well, that your part B is all mixed in with your part A. You have plenty of time to work with HXTAL, so you're not going to be in a hurry with this. Make sure everything's really mixed in well. You've gotten into every little area of your cup. And as I said, I'm just going to let this sit for a few hours and it'll degas on its own. And then we'll come back and bond with it. Now that we've mixed our color and we've mixed our part B into our part A, I've let it sit for a few hours so that it has degassed and it's gotten a little thicker over that time. So if you want to work with it when it's a little bit thinner, you can degas it with a vacuum system. But this is going to be perfectly fine for what I'm going to be doing today. So I'm going to measure this out and let's go ahead and bond this. There's my secondary piece, and these have already been cleaned. I've put the A1100 material on there, which is the adhesion promoter. I've re-cleaned it, so now we're just going to apply our top to our bottom. And we'll tape this up. And it's ready to cure. And now we've got our colored joint.